we move to Netflix. Next topic, Netflix getting into sports. John, what do you know about that?
There's an influential media analyst, Laura Martin of Needham, and she is not big on Netflix right now. She thinks Netflix needs to change its strategy. She thinks Netflix needs to add an advertising tier. She thinks Netflix needs to make a big purchase to get a big library of content to get out there. And interestingly enough, she thinks Netflix needs to look into live programming, which would mean sports and news. And so if Netflix makes that move, which would be a huge 180 to how they viewed the market as of now, look for the NBA. I think if there are digital companies that are really big in terms of moving into sports, the NBA and the NBA deal, which comes up in 2024, is going to be the one to look at.
That's interesting. Yeah, because if you're going to go, you got to go big probably. And that does make some sense. It costs a lot of money. The question is there a cap in terms of how many people and how many streaming networks they're going to have? But I do think as this becomes more of to the forefront of people's minds and they're thinking about, I have Disney Plus and Hulu and Netflix and HBO Max, et cetera, et cetera. They're starting to make decisions. And I have friends who aren't in the business who go from one, you know, like go get Apple for Ted Lasso, cut it. Go get Peacock and watch Yellowstone, cut it and move around. And so sports gives you that long tail. Like Peacock, when you look what they did with Premier League, or if you look what you know what ESPN has done with a variety of sports, you have that long tail because Premier League goes for 8, 9, 10 months of the year. So you're not gonna, if you like Premier League, you basically have, you're gonna have the service the whole year. And that's a guarantee that you don't have if you're trying to put, even if you're Amazon putting $500 million into a new Lord of the Rings series, you don't know that's going to work. Sports, you don't know how well it's gonna work on streaming, but you know you're gonna get at least some people, you know, and for them, hopefully all the people who were watching, that's the question we have, of course, about the young people. Well, are they interested in watching all these games?
Yeah, we're still several years away from this, from that happening. Right now, today in 2022, I got to believe that Turner and ESPN are going to renew the NBA. I think it's that important to both those companies. However, it's within the NBA's DNA to sort of do these out of the box deals. Remember, they were the first one to go all in with cable. And when they left NBC to go to ESPN, they have a younger fan base that would be more prone to streaming as well. So they're the ones that I'm really looking at. And they're, you know, I know the Big Ten is up and MLS is out there, but they're the next really big one from a national standpoint that's going to be coming up.